15 to 16 months.
Yeah.
Thanks for your help.
No, I don't let the guy.
I have a time what it is. I'm trying to get it out here on the end. Since our last meeting here, there's been one addition of furniture. I guess somebody thought that I could have some help with making decisions. And then you can say no if you want to. And you can say maybe. And the final one here is you can just say.
Are you going to leave it on that one?
Yes.
When did you all decide to move in there? Hey! I don't know where they said that.
Murray, I heard that.
You've been pretty well.
Well, I have some memory.
It's where I'm going to be.
Look at that. We've been flanked.
Bringing in reinforcements.
Just for better or worse. And yesterday I signed up 52 Democrats to endorse Ronald Reagan for re-election. Well, why don't we together and have a picture taken?
All right.
While they're still clean.
I think one.
Yes.
No, it's Chris.
Okay, Chris, right here.
This is a challenge.
Can you smile? Great. Big smile.
At me.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Well, I wish you well, but we're going to miss you.
Well, thank you, Mr. President. It's been a real honor. True honor for me.
Yes, sir. Read the citation for the Colonel's Award. Lieutenant Colonel Charles F. Brower of the 4th United States Army distinguished himself by exceptionally superior service as Army Aide to the President of the United States from August 1982 to July 1984. His responsibilities and position were unique and of paramount importance to the President and to the nation. He was responsible for planning and coordinating numerous events of national and international significance, requiring direct liaison with the most senior officials throughout the nation and around the world. Lieutenant Colonel Brower served as the officer responsible for supervising detailed arrangements and management of Department of Defense resources, supporting the complex logistical and scheduling requirements associated with Commander-in-Chief's travels. The successful accomplishments of those tasks, particularly those associated with the President's 1983 Far Eastern trip, contributed immeasurably to the Office of the President of the United States and to the effectiveness of the White House Military Office. The distinctive accomplishments of Lieutenant Colonel Brower reflect great credit upon himself, the United States Army, and the Department of Defense, for which the Defense Superior Service Medal is awarded.
Thank you, Mr. President. It's been a true honor.
Thank you. As I say, we'll miss you, but good luck.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much.
Oh. You might wish to be closer.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much. Right.
Sir, there's...
I know when they're old enough, they'll really appreciate it.
And that is a jar of jelly beans.
Which he'd love to get at immediately. We'll enjoy it. We're proud to have been here.
Yeah.
Thank you. It's been wonderful.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you for everything,
sir.
Appreciate it.
Yes, sir.
Thank you so much.
I'm going to have to get used to a whole lot of new faces.
Well, at least the uniform colors stay the same.
He's a cavalryman too, sir. My replacement.
Yes.
He's also a cavalryman.
He is?
Yes, sir.
And you'll enjoy him, I'm sure. And Kevin, enjoy the summer and a vacation that you earned.
Well, he's found a horse.
Oh,
well, thank you, sir. I know your time is important. Thank you, sir. Thanks
to you. Can you say goodbye? Thank you again.
You bet. Goodbye.
Thank you, Mr. President.